emptied a pot of lentils into the ashes for you. If you will pick them out again in 2 hours' time, you shall go to the ball with us.
And perhaps a sticky bun or four.
Birds in the sky, birds in the east, and the leaves in the fields, and the castles in the pond.
And a few of those pies.
Birds down from the east, and the leaves out of fields, out of castles and ponds. Swiftly sift through the ashes into the pot.
Listen well, son. Milky White must be taken to market.
But mother, no. It is the best cow.
Was. She's been tried for a week with no food nor money and no choice but to sell her while she can still command a price.
But Milky White is my best friend in the whole world.
Look at her. There are bugs on her dubs. There are flies in her eyes. There's a lump big enough to be a hump. But son, we've no time to sit and dither while our withers wither, wither. And no one keeps a cow for a friend. Sometimes I fear you're touched.
Into the woods it's time to go. I hate to leave, I have to though. Into the woods it's time, and so I must begin my journey. Into the woods and through the trees to where I am expected, ma'am. Into the woods to Grimm's house.
You are certain of
your way. The light and clear, the light and gun. I have no fear, nor no white gun. The woods are just trees, the trees are just wood. I sort of hate to ask it, but do you have a basket?
Now don't stray and be late.
And save some of those sweets for Granny.
Into the woods and down the dell, the path is straight, I know it well. Into the woods and who can tell what's waiting on the journey. Into the woods to bring some bread to Granny, who is sick in bed. Never can tell what lies ahead, for all that I know, she's already dead. Into the woods to Grandma's house to look before dark.
Birds back to the skies, back to the eaves and the leaves and the fields.
Hurry up and do my hair, Cinderella. Are you really wearing that? Here I found a little tear, Cinderella. Can't you hide it with a hat?
You look beautiful.
I know.
She means me.
What did it twist?
To be mothers to be good, fathers to be nice. That was always their advice. So be nice, Cinderella. Good, Cinderella. Nice, good, nice, kind, good. And,
Claude!
Because the baker had lost his mother and father in a baking accident. Well, at least that's what he believed. He was eager to have a family of his own, and all their efforts until now have failed.
Who might that be? Oh, it's the witch from next door.
We have sold our last loaf of
bread. We have no bread.
Oh, of course you have no bread.
What do you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish.
Nothing cooking in there, no!
Is there?
The old enchantress went on to tell the couple that she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. Oh, they were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors! You see, your mother was with child. She had developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and middlebird, and lettuce. He said, all right. But it wasn't quite, because I caught him in the autumn in my garden one night. He was robbing me, raping me, rooting through my rutabaga, raiding my arugula, ripping up the rapier, and my champion, my favorite. I should have laid a spell on him right there. Could have turned him into stone, or a dog, or a chair, or a slurring, and a slurring, and a slurring.
have the round here. I lost a spare. In return, however, I said fair is fair. You can let me have the baby that your wife will bear. And we'll call it square.
I had a brother.
No! What you had a sister.
But the witch refused to tell him any more of his sister. Not even that her name was Rapunzel.
I thought I had been more than reasonable. That we all might live happily ever after. But how was I to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket? You see, when I had inherited that gun, my mother warned me that I would be punished if I were to ever lose any of the beans. The special beans. I let him go. I didn't know he'd stolen my beans. I was watching him crawl back over the wall and then bang, crash, and the lightning flash. Oh, well, that's another story. Never mind. Anyway, at last the big day came. I made my claim. Oh, you take away the baby! They screamed and screeched, but I did. And I hid her where she'll never be reached. And your father cried. Your mother died. Went for extra measure. I admit it was a pleasure. I said, sorry. I'm still not mummified. And I laid a little spell on them. You too, son. That your family tree will always be a barren one. So, there's no more fuss and there's no more seed, and my garden thrives. You should see my nectarines, but I'm telling you the same. I tell kings and queens, don't ever, never, ever mess around with my dreams. Especially the beans!
Listen to me, Jim. Leave Milky Way to market. Fetch the best price you can. Take no less than £5. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Now, how much are you to ask?
No more than five.
Less than five!
Jack, Jack, Jack. Heavy the sap, the house is getting colder. This is not a time for dreaming. Chimney stack, starting to crack. The mice are getting bolder, the floor's gone slack. Your mother's getting older, your father's not back. And you can't just sit here dreaming pretty dreams. To wish and wait from day to day will never keep the into the woods, the time is now, we have to live, I don't care how. Into the woods to sell the cow, you must begin the journey. Straight through the woods and don't delay, we have to face the marketplace. Into the woods to journey's end.
Into the woods to sell a friend.
Someday you'll have a real pet, Jack.
A piggy?
Meanwhile, the witch, for purposes of her own, explained how the baker might lift the spell.
You wish to have the curse reversed? Ah! I'll need a certain potion first. Go to the wood and bring me back one, the cow as white as milk. Two, the cape as red as blood. Three, the hair as yellow as corn. Four, the slipper as pure as gold. Bring me these before the chime of midnight in 3 days' time, and you shall have, I guarantee, a child as perfect as child can be. Go to the wood!
Ladies! Okay, twins!
Now may I go to the festival?
The festival! Darling, those nails, darling, those hose, lentils are one thing, but darling, with those, you make us the fools of the festival, and mortify the parades!
The carriage is waiting!
We must be gone!
Good night, Father! I wish.
Look what I found in Father's hunting jacket!
Beans!
6 beans! I wonder if they're the...
Witch's beans! We'll take them with us!
No, you're not coming!
Well, I know you are fearful of the woods at night.
The spell is on my house. Only I can lift the spell.
No, no, the spell is on our house. We must lift the spell together.
No,
the spell is on our house.
You are not to come, and that is final. Now, what am I to return with?
You don't remember? The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
I still wish to go to the festival.
The cow is white as milk,
but how am I ever to get to the festival?
The hair is yellow as corn.
Only is it mother's grave,
the slipper is pure as gold.
And tell her I just want to carry the cape.
It's time to go, it may be all in vain. I go into the woods with even so. I have to take the journey
into the woods, the path is straight. I know it well, but who can tell?
Into the woods to lift the spell.
Into the woods to visit Father. Into the woods to fetch the things.
To make the potion.
To go to the festival. Into the woods without regret. The choice is made, the task is set.
Into the woods for not forgetting why I'm on the journey.
Into the woods to get my wish, I don't care how the time is now. Into the woods to sell the cow.
Into the woods to get the money.
Into the woods to lift the spell.
To make the potion.
To go to the festival.
Woods to Grandmother's house. Into the woods to Grandmother's house.
The way is clear, the life is good. I have no fear, nor no one should. The woods are just trees, the trees are just wood. No need to be afraid. Into the woods, who knows what may be lurking on the journey. Into the woods to get the thing that makes it worth the journey. Into the woods to see the king,
to sell the cow,
to make the potion, to see, to sell, to get, to bring, to make, to lift, to go to the vessel. Into the woods, into the woods, into the woods, and out of the woods. And home before dark.
Come along, Milky White. There are spirits here. young lady.
Good day, mister.
Where did you wait so hurriedly?
To my grandmother's.
And what might be in your basket?
Bread and wine, so grandmother will have something good to make her strong.
God, where might grandmother live?
A good quarter of a league further in the woods. Her house stands under three large oak trees.
Look at the flesh, pink and plump. Hello, little girl. Tender and fresh, not one lump. Hello, little girl. This one's especially lush, delicious. Hello, little girl, what's your rush? You're missing all the flowers. The sun won't set for hours. Take your time.
Mother said straight ahead, not to delay or be misled.
But slow, little girl, hark and hush. The birds are singing sweetly. You'll miss the birds completely. You're traveling so fleetly. Grandmother first, and Miss Plump. What a delectable couple. And at perfection, one bread, one supple, one moment.
Mother said, from one day, follow the path and never stray.
Just so, little girl, any path to many worth exploring. Just one would be so boring. Look what you're ignoring. Think of those crisp, aging bones. And something fresh on the palate. Think of that scrumptious carnality twice in one day. There's no possible way to describe what you feel when you're talking to your me.
Mother said not to stray, still I suppose a small delay. Granny might like a fresh bouquet. Goodbye. Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, little girl. And hello.
Hello, sir.
What are you doing with a cow in the middle of the forest?
I was heading to a market, but I seem to have lost my way.
And what were you planning to do?
And what were you planning on doing?
Sell my cow, sir. No less than 5 pounds.
5 pounds? Where am I going to get 5 pounds?
She must be generous of milk to fetch 5 pounds.
Yes.
And if you were unable to fetch that sum, then what were you planning to do?
I hadn't thought of that. I suppose my mother and I will have no food to eat.
This is the sum total.
Beans? We mustn't part with any of our beans. Well, if you feel we must. Beans will bring you food, son.
Beans in exchange for my cow?
Oh, these are no ordinary beans. These beans contain magic.
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell him!
Magic! That defies description.
My mother would...
You'd be lucky to exchange her for a sack of beans!
How many beans?
6!
5! We mustn't give up all of our beans. We should keep one for ourselves. Besides, I'd say that they're worth a pound each at the very least.
Could I buy my cow back someday?
Well, possibly. Well, good luck there, young lad.
I guess this is goodbye, old pal. You've been a perfect friend. I hate to see us part, old pal. Someday I'll buy you back. I'll see you soon again. I hope that when I do, it won't be on a plate.
Take the cow and go home.
I was trying to be helpful.
Magic beans. We've no reason to believe that they're magic. Are we going to dispel this curse through deceit?
No one would have given him more for this creature. We did them a favor. At least now they'll have some food.
Now 5 beans!
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you get it.
Home.
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take and you bid and you bargain or you live to regret it.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in-betweens. No one waits when fortune intervenes. And maybe they're really magic. Who knows? Why do what you do? That's the point. All the rest of it is chatter.
Look at her, she's crying.
If the thing you do is pure in intent and it's meant and it's just a little bent, does it matter?
Yes!
No, it matters is that everyone tells tiny lies. What's important really is the size.
What?
Only 3 more tries and we'll have our prize. When the end's in sight, you'll realize if the end is right, it justifies the beans.
I will carry this out in my own fashion.
Yeah. As for Rapunzel, the witch was careful not to lose its beauty to the outside world, and so shut her within a doorless tower that lay deep within the woods. And whenever the witch paid a visit, she called,
Ha 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 ha! My goodness, can you pull me a little harder, darling? Yes! Yes! Satisfaction! Just the best! Yes, yes, yes.
Oh, wait. Rapunzel. Rapunzel. What a strange name. Strange, beautiful, and fit for a prince. Tomorrow, before that horrible witch arrives, I will stand before her window and ask her to let her hair down to me.
Hello, little one.
Hello.
You saved some of those sweets for Granny?
I ate all the sweets and half a loaf of bread.
Whoa, where did you get that beautiful cloak? I so admire it.
My Granny made it for me.
Is that right? I would love a red cloak like that.
You'd look pretty foolish.
May I take a look at it?
I don't like to be without my coat. Please, give it back!
I want it badly. I just wanted to make sure that you really love that red cape. Now, you go on to your granny's house and make sure that no wolf comes your way.
I'd rather wolf than you any day.
When you know what you need, and you go, and you find it, and you take it. Do I want a child or not? It's a cloak. What's a cloak? It's a joke. It's a stupid little cloak. And a cloak is what you make it, so you take it. Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them more.
And so the baker, with newfound determination, went after the red cape. As for the little girl... she was surprised to find Grandmother's cottage door standing open.
Perhaps it's from all the sweets. Good day, Grandmother. My Grandmother, you're looking very strange. What big ears you have.
The better to hear you with, my dear.
But Grandmother, what big eyes you have.
The better to see you with, my dear.
But Grandmother, what large hands you have.
The better to hug you with, my dear.
Oh, Grandmother, what a terrible, big, wet mouth you have.
Better to eat you with.
And with a single bound, he was devouring the little
Grandmother is a mighty snorer. Odd. Where's the little one? Eating, no doubt. Or eating. Oh, Grandmother, huh? What is that piece of red cloth in the corner of your mouth? Oh, looks to me to be a piece of the... Oh, I will take that cloak from within your stomach!
Oh, what a fright! How
to danger was inside that wolf! Yeah!
Oh, 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 oh.
He's a very nice prince, and
very nice ball.
And
then, when I enter, they trumpet.
And
the prince.
Oh, yes, the prince.
But he's tall.
Is that all?
Did you dance? Is he charming?
They say that he's charming.
He did nothing but dance.
Yes.
And it made a nice change.
Oh, the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
He has charm for a prince, I guess.
Yes.
I don't mean wide range. It's all very strange.
Are you to return to the festival tomorrow, Eve?
Perhaps.
Oh, perhaps. Oh, to be pursued by a prince. All that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. What I wouldn't give to be in your shoes.
Look over there. An enormous vine growing into that little cottage.
In the sky, there are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky.
Good fortune! Good fortune! Look what I have!
Here is 5 gold pieces.
5 gold pieces?
Oh, where's Milky White?
Milky White is at home with my wife.
Let's go find them.
Wait!
I don't know that I wish to tell.
You said I could buy her back.
I'm not sure that 5 gold pieces.
Are you saying that you wish for money?
More money. Oh.
Keep this. I will go fetch more.
No, wait. I didn't say. 5 gold pieces. With this, I could buy baking supplies for a whole year. I could buy a new thatch roof and a new chimney.
What could you buy yourself, a child?
Who are you?
When first I appear, I seem delirious. When explained, I'm nothing serious. Could you buy yourself a child?
I don't understand.
How badly do you wish a child? 5 gold pieces, 10, 20.
I never thought to put a price on that.
Exactly. You've not thought about many things, have you, son?
Give me back the money. That money is not yours.
No, nor is it Jack's. The money's not what's important. What's important is your wish be honored.
No, give me back that. Damn! Come back here with my...
Oh, I see you've the red cape.
Yes, I have the cape. Only 2 items left to locate.
3.
2. I have the cape and the cow.
You have the cape.
What happened to the cow?
She ran away. I never reached home. I've been looking for her all night.
I should have known better than to have trusted her to you.
She might just as easily have run from you.
But she didn't.
But she might have.
But she didn't.
But she might have.
Who cares?
The cape is gone! Get it back! I mean the car, for God's sake, get it!
Get it back!
We were just going to do that. Here, I can't give you the cape.
Don't give me that! I don't want to touch that fool, don't you? Don't you understand?
Very talented.
By tomorrow's midnight, bring me the items, or you'll be sorry you ever thought to wish to have a child.
I don't like that woman.
I'm sorry I lost the cow.
I shouldn't have yelled. Now, will you please go back to the village? I will make things right. And then we can just go about our lives. No more hunting about the woods for strange objects. No more witches and dim-witted little boys and hungry little girls. Go.
Where you had gone.
I've been looking all night for her. The beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared like the fine morning mist.
She was lovely.
The loveliest.
I am not certain of that. I must confess, I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives here in the woods.
The woods?
Yes, in the top of a tall tower with no door or stair.
Where?
2 leagues from here, due east, just beyond the mossy knoll.
And how do you manage a visit?
I stand before her tower and say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And then she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel! What kind of a name is that? Yes, I've never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth. She is as true as your maiden. A maiden running from a prince. why none would run from us.
Yet one has. Did I abuse her, show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony, be your power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Life and becoming, and frequently humming, a light-hearted air. Agony, far more painful than yours. When you know she would go with you, if there only were doors.
Agony, oh, the torture they teach.
What's as intriguing,
half so fatiguing,
as what's out of reach?
Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, an heir to a throne?
You are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why no?
Do I know?
The girl must be mad.
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair, and you see her up there, and you're nearing her all the while hearing her.
Always 10 steps behind,
always 10 feet below,
and she's just out of reach. Agony that can cut like a knife. I must have her to
Oh, I'd say those slippers were as pure as gold. beauty. Oh, what I wouldn't give for just one. One isn't likely to do you much good. Oh, was the ball just as wonderful as last evening? Oh, it's still a nice ball. Yes, and they have far too much food. No, the prince. Oh, the prince. Yes, the prince. If he knew who I really was. Oh, who? I'm afraid I was rude.
Oh, how?
Now I'm being pursued.
Yes, and
I'm not in the mood.
Oh, he must have really taken a liking to you.
I have no experience with princes and castles and girls.
Well, that's nonsense.
Every girl dreams.
Look, sir, look!
Oh,
sir!
And I must have your shoe!
Yes, that's you!
I stole it!
Oh, move! Where did she go?
Who?
Oh, don't play the fool, woman.
Oh, you mean that beautiful young woman in a ball gown? Oh, she went this way. I tried to hold her here for you, but she's...
I can capture my own damsel.
No,
thank you.
Yes, sir.
Where did he go?
Who? The principal!
Oh, the prince! He went that way, but you'll never catch him.
Oh, we would have if that mongrel with the cow hadn't molested us.
Oh, cow.
Please, let me just compare this color with that of your own.
He wants to compare our hair to court.
Our hair! Oh, I thought you were returning home. I've had no luck.
You've the cow.
Yes, I've the cow. I've only two of the four.
Three.
Two.
Three. Compare this to your ear of corn.
Oh, where did you find it?
I pulled it from a maiden in a tower. Had the fourth, but she got away.
Oh, we've one entire day left. Surely we can find the slipper by then.
We? You mean you'll allow me to stay?
Well, perhaps it might take the two of us to get this child.
You've changed. You're tearing. You're different in the woods. More sure, more sharing. You're getting us through the wood. If you could see, you're not the man who started. You're much more open-hearted than I knew you to be.
It takes two. I thought one was enough. It's not true. It takes two of us. You came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It took two of us. It takes care. It takes patience and fear and despair to change. Despair to change. Can't tell if you do. It takes two.
You've changed. You're thriving. There's something about the woods. Not just surviving. You're blossoming in the woods. At home, I fear we'd stay the same forever. And then out here, you're passionate, charming, considerate, clever.
It takes one to begin, but then once you've begun, oh, it takes two of you. It's no fun. What needs to be done, you can do. When there's two of you, if I dare, it's because I'm becoming aware of us as a pair of us. It's accepting a share of what's there.
We've changed. We're strangers. I'm meeting you in the world. Who minds what dangers? I know we'll get past the world. And once we're past, let's hope these changes last. Beyond boots, beyond witches and slippers and hoods, just the two of us, beyond lies, safe at home with our beautiful prize. Just a few of us, it takes trust. It takes just a bit more when we're done. We got four, we had one, we got three. We got one, it takes two.
Look at this hand dropped in my hand.
A golden egg! I've never seen a golden egg before.
You more than the 5 gold pieces I gave you, sir.
5 gold pieces?
Now take him a cow.
5 gold pieces?
No, I never said I would sell.
But you took the 5 gold pieces.
You took 5 gold pieces?
I didn't take, he gave.
Well, where are the 5 gold pieces?
An old man.
You said I could have my cow.
I never said you could, I said you might.
You would take money before a child?
Resign yourself to living a childless life.
I think it best if you go for the cow, as I have met a maiden these 2 previous eves with a golden slipper, and I think I might succeed in obtaining one of them.
Fine.
Fine.
That is simply...
fine!
Unfortunately for Rapunzel, the witch discovered her affections for the prince before he could scare her away. I clearly say, children must listen.
No, no, please, I...
What were you not to do? Children must see and to learn. Why could you not obey? Children should listen. What have I been to you? What would you have me be? Handsome like a prince. You are ashamed of me!
No!
You are ashamed! You don't understand.
It was lonely atop that tower.
I was not company enough. I am no longer a child. I wish to see the world. Don't you know what's out there in the world? Someone has to shield you from the world. Stay with me. Princess, wait there in the world. It's true. Princess, yes, but wolves. And humans too. Stay at home. I am home. Who out there could love you more than I? What out there that I cannot supply? Stay with me.
yes, you disobeyed me.
But did you think I was saying that?
You lied to me. Why didn't you tell me you had a visitor? I will not share you, but I will show you a world you've never seen.
No! No! Why did you? No! No!
What is a white cow, not a white cow?
I don't know. Leave me alone.
But haven't I left you alone long enough?
Your questions make no sense, old man!
In need of another cow.
Oh! What a beautiful cape!
Stay away from my cape, or I'll slice you into a thousand bits.
No, I don't want it. I was just admiring it.
My granny made it for me from a wolf that attacked us. And I got to skin the animal, and best of all, she gave me this beautiful knife for protection.
Well, look what I have, a hen that lays golden eggs.
I don't believe that egg came from that hen. Where did you get that egg?
I stole it from the kingdom of the giant up there. And if you think this is something, you should see the golden harp that the giant has. It plays the most beautiful tunes without you even having to touch it.
Of course it does. Why don't you go up to the kingdom right now and bring it back down and show me?
I could.
You could not.
I could.
You could not.
I am not a liar. I will get that harp. You'll see.
After having cast out Rapunzel to a remote desert, the witch returned to take the prince by surprise, and as he fell from the tower, the thorns into which he fell pierced his eyes and blinded him. As for Cinderella, she returned from her final visit to the festival. He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares, knowing this time I'd run from him. He's been pitched on the stairs. I was caught unawares, and I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing there stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? You think, make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, it's a thought, what would be his response? You think, what if he knew who you were when you know that you're not what he thinks that he wants? And then what if you are what a prince would envision? Although, how can you know who you are till you know what you want, but you don't? So which do you pick? Where you're safe out of sight in yourself, but where everything's wrong? Or where everything's right and you know that you'll never belong? Oh, and whichever you pick, do it quick, because you're starting to stick to the steps of the palace. It's your first big decision. The choice isn't easy to make. To arrive at a ball is exciting and all, but you're there though it's scary. And it's fun to deceive when you know you can leave, but you have to be wary. There's lots that's at stake, but just stall long enough, because you're still standing stuck in the stuff on the steps. Better run on home and avoid the collision. Even though they don't care, you'll be better off there. But there's nothing to choose, so there's nothing to lose. So you pry up your shoes. You're out of the pool, without any guide. You know what your decision is, which is not to decide. Just leave him a clue. For example, a shoe. And then see what he'll do. Now it's he and not you who is stuck with a shoe in a stew, in the goo.
And you've learned something too, something you never knew. On the steps of the palace!
Stay away from me! Please hear me out! Oh no, we have nothing to discuss! You have attacked me once before!
No, I did not attack you! I attacked your shoe! I need it!
Here. Here is a magic bean in exchange for it. Magic bean? Nonsense!
Oh, don't do that!
I have already given up one shoe this evening.
I need that shoe to have a child. That makes no sense. Does it make sense that you are running from a prince?
Stop!
Here, take my shoes. You'll run faster.
Who was that woman?
I do not know.
Lying will cost you your life.
I've done nothing.
I've the cow.
I've the shoe we fought for.
And I will give this to the prince. And tomorrow we will search the kingdom for the maiden who will fit this shoe.
That's mine. I don't care if it costs me my life. No, give that to me. That is mine. Give
it to me. Give me a slipper and all will come to a happy...
What was that noise?
Oh, sir, that was just a bolt of lightning in a far-off kingdom.
How dare you take off in search without me?
Oh, my apologies, sir, I just thought that I...
Enough of what you thought.
Yes.
I employed a ruse, had the entire staircase smeared with pitch, and there when she ran down remained a maiden slipper.
Brilliant.
I thought so. It did create quite a mess when the other guests slept.
And, sir, I have succeeded in obtaining the other slipper. Give them the slipper, and all will come to a happy end.
Who are you, old man?
Yeah. Well, when first I appear, I seem deleterious.
Shut up.
Do as he says. He's obviously a spirit of some sort, and we only need one.
There's a dead giant in my backyard! I heard Jack coming down the beanstalk, calling for his axe. And when he reached the bottom, he began hacking down the stalk. Suddenly, with a crash, the beanstalk fell. But there was no Jack. For all I know, he's been crushed by the ogre.
Worrying will do you no good. If he's safe, then he's safe. If he's been crushed, well, then there's nothing any of us can do about that now, is there? We must be off. I need my rest before tomorrow's search is to commence.
Does no one care? A giant has fallen from the sky!
He is dead, is he not?
With such a thud, I would suppose!
The third midnight is here! We have all the ingredients.
Yes, the slipper, the hair.
Okay, the cow.
The cow doesn't look as white as milk to me.
Oh, she is, she is.
The cow has been covered with flour.
We had a cow as white as milk, honestly, we
then
did.
Then where is she? She's dead.
We thought you'd prefer a live cow.
Of course I'd prefer a live cow. So bring in a dead one and I'll bring her back to life.
You can do that?
No!
There you are! I was worried, Sam!
Mother, look! The most beautiful heart!
You have stolen too much! You could have been killed coming down that plant!
She's too heavy!
Milky White! Yes! Now I have two friends! A cow and a heart.
Quiet! Feed the objects to the cow!
What?
You heard me! Feed them to the cows!
Don't move!
Fill
milk for me. Squeeze, pal.
Call ingredients! Forget about a child!
No! No, wait! We gave you what you asked for. One, that cow was as white as milk, correct?
Yes!
And two, the cake was certainly as red as blood.
Yes!
And three, the slipper.
Yes!
And four, he compared the hair to this ear of corn.
I pulled it from a maiden in a towel.
You what? What were you doing there?
I happened to be...
I touched the hair! Don't you understand? I cannot have touched the ingredients!
The corn! The corn! What a silky hair of the corn! Pull it from the ear and feed it to the cow quickly!
Does that better work, old man, before the last stroke of midnight, or your child, your son, will be the last of your flesh and blood?
Son, please, not now.
Yes, meet your father.
Father! Is that for you? I thought you died in a baking accident.
I didn't want to run away from you, son, but...
It's working!
She's milking! I don't understand.
No, give me the cup.
It's not for you, idiot!
Where are you going? We've given you what you wish.
Now what can we expect a child? What's happening?
Son! Son!
Father!
Father! All is prepared!
He's dead.
And so the mysterious man died, having helped end the curse on his house. For the baker, there would be no reunion with his father, and he and his wife, bewildered, returned home. The witch, who had been punished for the age of ugliness that night when her beads had been stolen, and the lightning flashed, was now returned to her former state of youth and beauty. And Milky White, after a night of severe indigestion, was reunited with the now wealthy Jack. As for the prince, he began his search for the butcher with the golden slipper. When it came to Cinderella's house, Cinderella's stepmother took the slipper into Florinda's room.
Careful, my tall
darling, I know.
What'll we do?
You have to go, and when you're his bride, you can sit or ride. You'll never need to walk.
The girl obeyed, swallowing the pain, and joined the prince on his horse, riding off to become his bride. Look at the blood within the shoe. This one is not the bride, that's true. Search for the fourth that beats. The prince returned the false bride and asked the other sister to put on the slipper.
You might want it fit, darling, be still. Cut off a bit of the heel and it will. And when you're his wife, you'll have such a life. You'll never need to walk.
The girl obeyed and swallowed her pain. But as she was helped on the back of the horse by the prince, he noticed blood trickling from the shoe.
Oh! Have you no other daughters?
No. Only a stunted little kitchen wench that his late wife left behind. But she is much too dirty. She cannot show herself.
I insist!
And when Cinderella presented herself and tried on the blood-soaked slipper, it fit like a glove.
This is the true bride.
I always wanted a son.
Now I'm ordinary, but I'm happy, happy, no one happy, and that's why. once upon a time. Later, I wish in the same far-off kingdom,
more than anything,
the young princess, like the lad Jack,
I wish
the baker and his family.
No, I miss more than anything, Lord Lamon.
There, for a festival. I wish to sponsor a festival.
More than richer.
Oh.
I miss my kingdom up in the sky.
I wish we had more room. But despite some minor inconveniences, they were all content. I never thought I'd wed a prince.
I never thought I'd find perfection.
I never thought I could be so happy.
Nothing had been more than serious.
If we'd be this rich,
conceivable objects.
I thought we'd have a baby.
I could be so happy.
Happy now, happy hence, happy ever after.
We're so happy, you're so happy.
Just as long as you stay happy,
this
being
happy.
That one
brown. Pots of pets.
With my cow.
Little gurgle.
Darling, I must go now.
We should really sell it.
Where's the cheese box?
We should stay bring problems such that you regret them.
Better that though than to never get them. I'm going to be a perfect wife.
I'm going to see that he is so happy.
Why expand when we could simply move to another cottage?
Oh, this is my father's house. It would be my son's.
You would raise your child alongside a witch?
Why does he always cry when I hold him?
Babies cry. You needn't hold him as if he were so fragile.
No. He wants his mother. Here.
I can't take care of him all the time.
I will take care of him when he's older. Are you all right?
I think so.
Okay.
He's fine. Are you all right?
You! Did you do this to our house?
Always thinking of yourself. Look at my garden. What of your garden? Look!
Destroyed.
What happened? I saw nothing. I was thrown to the ground. What could do such a thing?
An earthquake.
No earthquake. My garden has been trampled. Those are footprints. Who could do such a thing?
Anything that leaves a footprint that large is no who.
Do you think it was a bear?
A bear? Bears are sweet. Besides, you ever see a bear with 40-foot feet?
A dragon. No scorch marks. Usually they're licked.
Manticore.
Imagine it.
Griffin.
Think extinct.
Giant.
Possible!
Very, very
possible.
A giant!
Maybe we should tell someone.
Oh?
Who are you going to tell?
The royal family, of course. Oh,
the royal family? I wouldn't count on that family to snuff out a rat.
But the giant, we'll all have to go to battle. A giant's the worst. A giant has a brain. Hard to outwit a giant. Giants are just like us, only bigger. Much, much bigger. So big that we're just an expendable bug beneath its foot. Boom!
We are moving.
Oh, look, Mookie White, it's the butcher.
The baker.
Baker.
Speaking for you, sir.
I have come to investigate the destruction that was wrought upon our house today.
Jack's been home with me all day.
I fear there's a giant in the land.
Oh, I can recognize a giant's footsteps, and I could go to your house. You'll do no such thing.
Or any help at all.
You'll get none from us. No one cared when there was a giant in my backyard. I don't remember you volunteering to come to my aid.
Well, a giant in your backyard is one thing, a crushed home is quite another.
I wouldn't worry, young man. Giants never strike the same house twice.
I am taking the news to the castle nevertheless.
Excuse me, madam. This small man insists on seeing you.
Princess, I have come to report the appearance of a giant in the land.
Where did you see a giant?
Well, I didn't actually see it.
Then how do you know that there's a giant in the land?
Because our house was destroyed in their footprints.
That could have been caused by any number of things. I will show you to the door.
Wait!
A neighboring household was visited by a giant not too long ago, descending from a beanstalk.
Yes, I remember.
That giant was slain. Now come along.
Wait. We have a small child. Princess, our child was very hard to come by. His safety is of great importance to me.
Are we entirely through now?
Yeah.
I will take this news up with the prince when he returns. Thank you.
I'm off to sell the harp, Jack.
Mother, no!
Listen to me, Jack. We don't want that harp around here when there's a giant on loose.
I know how to kill a giant.
Oh, please. We've had our fill of giants.
But, Mother, if I could help...
Listen to me, son. I don't want you to leave your surroundings.
But, Mother, I am a man now.
You'll always be a little boy in your mother's eyes. Now I want you to promise. Promise.
I promise.
What happened to your house?
We had a baking accident.
Baking accident?
There's no use frightening the young thing.
You can't frighten her.
Well, I guess Granny will have to do without the bread and sweets. Besides, I have all that I can carry.
Why such a load?
Oh, I'm moving in with Granny. We had an accident too. I came home to find our house collapsed, as if a big wind blew it in. I couldn't find my mother anywhere.
Oh no.
So I salvaged what I could, and now I am off.
Oh, good friends! What news?
What a mother's grave? What kind of trouble? No, I can't go out and investigate. A princess is not supposed to go into the woods unescorted.
Good idea. I will disguise myself and go to see what's wrong. Thank you, Bert.
We'll take you to Granny's house.
What?
Oh, yes, we're not going to let her go alone.
All right, I'll take you.
I don't need anyone to take me. I've been many times before.
But not when there's been such a big wind blowing.
He's right. We'll all go.
No, you stay here.
I'm not about to stay alone with the baby when such a wind might return to this house, too.
I know my mother made me promise, but I'm going to find that giant anyway.
Into the woods, it's always when you think it lasts your fruit. And then into the woods you go again to take another journey.
Into the woods, the weather's clear. We've been before, we've not to fear. Into the woods, away from here.
Into the woods to find a giant.
Into the woods to grandmother's house.
Into the woods, a path of strange, no reason then to hesitate. Into the woods, it's not so late, it's just another journey. Into the woods, where rocks are bald, the skies are strange, the winds are strong. Into the woods to see what's wrong.
Into the woods to slay the giant.
Into the woods to shield the child.
To flee the winds.
To find a future.
To shield.
Slay.
To flee.
To find.
To fix. To hide.
To move.
Battle.
To see what the trouble is.
Rapunzel? Oh! What are you doing here? What's the matter?
Oh, nothing. You just locked me in a tower without company for all my life. Then, like the prince, then banished me to a desert! Why, little to eat, and again, no company. And then, poor twins! Because of the way you treated me, I will never, never be happy.
I was just trying to be a good mother.
coming up.
Out!
Good brother, what a surprise!
Brother, how good to see you.
What brings you into the woods today?
I am investigating news of a giant.
You investigating news of a giant? Father would not even do that. That is news. That is business for your steward,
or less.
Well, what brings you into the wood?
My Rapunzel has run off.
Run off?
She's a changed woman. She has been subject to hysterical fits of crying, moods no soul could predict, and I'm not what to do.
What a pity.
And Cinderella?
She remains well.
Oh, does she? Oh. Now, brother, you tell. What are you really doing here?
Yours was when I had beauty to sleep. All round the tower, thick and a briar, 100 feet deep. Agony, no frustration more keen. When the one thing you want is a thing that you've not even seen.
I found a casket entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside, don't ask it, a maiden, alas, just as unwakeable.
What unmistakable
agony is the way always barred. She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
There's a dwarf standing guard. Agony, that princes must weep.
Always enthralled to anything, almost something asleep. If it were not for the thicket,
a thicket's no trick, is it thick?
It's the thickest.
A thickness, pick it apart with a stick.
Yes, but even one prick, it's my thing about blood.
Well, it's sick.
It's no sicker than your thing with dwarves.
Dwarves.
Some sorts are very
upsetting.
Now, can't hear the test. Unachievable, mountains unscalable. If it's conceivable, but unavailable.
Cry on their fears.
What unbearable bliss.
Agony that can cut like a knife.
Ah, well, back to my
strike the same house twice.
You heard wrong.
Shh.
a woman!
The size!
Where is the lad who killed my husband?
There is no lad here!
You haven't seen him?
I want the lad who climbed the beanstalk.
We'll get him for you right away! Don't move!
It was you who destroyed our house, not a great wind! It's because of you I have no mother!
And who destroyed my house? That boy asked for shelter, and then he stole our gold, our head, and our heart. And then he killed my husband. I must avenge the wrongdoings.
We are not responsible for him!
Don't waste your breath.
She's right, you can't reason with a dumb giant.
Not all giants are dumb. Give me the boy.
We told you, Jack's not here!
And the little girl's right!
I know he's there. And I'm going to wait right here until he's delivered to me.
Put a spell on her!
I no longer have my powers. If I did, you think I'd be standing here with all of you? Listen. We'll have to give her someone.
Who?
The steward. It's in his line of duty to sacrifice his life.
Don't be ridiculous. I am not giving up my life for anybody.
Take it personally?
I'm waiting.
Excuse me. Take a blind girl instead.
What? How dare you?
Put them out of their misery.
We're not that miserable.
What are you talking about?
She doesn't want a woman.
No. Fine. Then what do you suggest we do?
I'm still waiting.
No! I tell the story! I'm not part of it!
That's right!
Not one of us!
They're always on the outside!
That's my role! You must understand! There must always be someone on the outside!
You're gonna be on the inside now!
You're making a big mistake!
Nonsense!
You need an objective observer to pass the story along!
Some of us don't like the way you've been telling it!
Yes!
That's all!
Get out! Thank you.
condition.
Wake up. No, let them in chair. We won't. Promise me. You promise me you won't let him be hurt as I lay here at death's door.
I'll do all I can.
Promise. Promise.
Right, all right, I promise.
No. No, you stay away from there. You killed him.
I was thinking of the greater good. That's my job.
This is the world I meant. Couldn't you listen? Couldn't you stay content, safe behind walls?
Stay here with the baby. Please.
always argue like that?
No, not always.
It seems like you do.
And there's nothing wrong with having an argument.
Oh, I see.
Okay! Okay!
Oh, it's him!
Jack!
Jack! Look! You sit here with the baby!
No, I want to come!
You'll be safer here!
Don't go too far, please!
I will only go 100 paces, and if I do not find the boy, I will come right back. One, two, three, four. Jack! 81, 82, 83. Oh, hello, sir!
Hello!
You must be here to slay the giant!
Yes!
Have you seen the giant?
No!
I have!
You have?
Yes.
What are you doing alone in the woods?
Oh, well, I'm here with my husband. We were just... Well, it's a long story.
He would let you roam alone in the woods?
No. It was my choice, actually. I'm looking for the lad.
Your choice?
Yes.
How brave.
Brave?
Yeah. Anything can happen in the woods. May I kiss you? Any moment we could be crushed.
Huh?
Don't feel rushed.
This is ridiculous. What am I doing here? I'm in the wrong story.
Well, yes.
And I have a baker.
Of course, you're right. A foolish. Foolishness can happen in the woods. Once again, please, let your hesitations be hushed. Any moment, big or small, is a moment. After all, seize a moment, skies may fall any longer. Right and wrong don't matter in the woods. Only feelings let us speak a moment unblushed. Life is often so unpleasant. You must know that as a peasant, best to take the moment present as a present for the moment.
Jack. Oh, excuse me, ma'am. May I be at your service?
The tree has fallen. Mother's grave destroyed.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
My wishes have just been crushed.
Don't say that.
It's true. You wouldn't understand.
Well, I can't stay here. There's a giant on the loose.
I'm sure the prince will see to it that the giant is rid from our land.
There's been no sign of the prince. No doubt he's off seducing some young maiden somewhere.
What?
Well, I understand. That's what princes do.
Not all princes.
You look just like the princes. But dirty. You are the princess!
Oh, please, no, get up! I'm not a princess here.
What are you to do?
I must be on my way back to the castle.
Have you heard? I came across the royal family. The castle's been set upon by the giant.
And the prince?
He was not with them. You must come with me. You'll be safe in our company.
The giant!
Oh, yes! The giant! I had almost forgotten. Will we find each other in the woods again?
This was just a moment in the woods. A moment shimmering.
be glad for the moment that we have. Every moment is a moment when you're in the womb. I must go off and slay a giant now. That is what the next moment holds for me. I shall not forget you. How brave you are to be alone in the woods, and how alive you made me feel.
What was that? Was that me? Was that him? Did a prince really kiss me? And kiss me? And kiss me? And did I kiss him back? Am I wrong? Am I mad? Is that all? Does he miss me? Was he suddenly getting bored with me? Wake up, stop dreaming, stop prancing about the woods. It's not me seeming, what is it about the woods? Back to life, back to sense, back to child, back to husband, no one lives in the woods. There are vows, there are ties, there are needs, there are standards, there are shouldn'ts and shoulds. Why not both instead? There's the answer if you're clever. Whatever. Never, it's these woods. Face the facts, find the boy, join the group, stop the giant, just get out of the woods. Was that him? Yes, it was. Was that me? No, it wasn't. Just a trick of the woods. Just a moment. One peculiar passing moment. Must it all be either less or more, either plain or grand? Is it always or is it never end? That's what woods are for these moments in the woods. Oh, if life were made of moments, even now and then a bad one. But if life were only moments, witch, then a child, then a prince, then a moment, who can live in the woods? And to get what you wish, even just for a moment, these are dangerous woods. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, though. Just remembering you've had an end when you're back to war makes the or mean more than it did before. Now I understand, and it's time to leave the woods.
Where did you find this?
What happened to my wife?
Gah! She's dead.
What?
I'm sorry, sir. I came upon her, she was under a tree. She was sobbing over her like she was his own mother.
Oh. How could this happen?
I buried her in a footprint.
What was I thinking? I should have just stayed here with her.
Remorse will get you nowhere.
My wife is dead!
Wake up! People are dying all around you! You think you're the only one to suffer a loss? When you're dead, you're dead. Now it's time to get that boy to the giant before we're all so much dead.
No,
you keep away from him!
No!
This is no time to be soft-hearted! That boy is going to the giant and I'm taking him!
Yes, he's to blame. It's because of you that there is a giant in our midst and my wife is dead.
But it is my fault I was given those beans. You persuaded me to trade away my cow for beans. Without those beans, there'd have been no stuff to get up to the giant in the first place.
Wait a minute, magic beans for a cow so old. And you had to tell a lie to sell it when you told. Were they worthless beans? Were they oversold? Oh, and tell us who persuaded you to steal that gold.
It's your fault.
No, it's your fault.
No. Yes, it is.
It's not.
It's true.
Wait a minute, though. I only stole the gold to get my cow back from you.
So it's your fault.
Yes.
No, it isn't. I kept those beans, but our house was cursed. She made us get a cow to get the curse reversed.
It's his father's fault that the curse got placed and the place got cursed in the first place.
Oh, then it's his fault.
It was his fault.
No.
Yes, it is. It's his.
Oh, yes.
Wait a minute, though. I chopped down the beanstalk, right? That's clear. But without any beanstalk, then what's clear is how did the second giant get down here in the first place? Second place?
Yes.
Yes.
Mm. Well, who had the other bean?
The other bean?
Other bean?
You pocketed the other bean.
I didn't. Yes, I did.
So it's your fault.
No, it isn't. I gave it to my wife.
So it's your fault.
No, it isn't.
What is it?
Wait a minute, she
excuse that bean to attain your shoe. So the one who knows what happened to the bean is you.
And that old bean that your wife pulled in, but I never knew it, so it's what don't look here!
So it's your fault!
See, it's her fault, and it isn't mine at all.
What?
You had gone back up again!
We were needy.
You were greedy. Did you need that pen?
But I got it from my mother.
So it's her fault then!
Is it one from the harp in
the
first
harp, yes!
She went and dared me to!
I dared you to!
You dared me to! She said that I was scared to! You dared me!
No, I didn't!
It was her fault!
I
and you had left the harp alone.
Well, you had in trouble with the bean in the first place.
She had
the
syrup in the first place.
Raise the bean
in the first place.
It's your fault. You're responsible.
You're
the one that went your fault.
Your father, just like you will be too. Oh, my father. yours! Separate and alone! Everybody down on all fours! All right, Mother, when? Lost the beads again! Punish me the way you did then! Give me claws and a hunch! Just away from this bunch! And the globe, and the door, and the floor!
From the giant.
Maybe I shouldn't have strayed from the path.
Maybe I shouldn't have attended the ball.
Yes, maybe you shouldn't have. Where are you going?
Away from here.
But you said we had to find our way out of this together.
It doesn't matter if we're together or apart.
We need your help.
Oh. You don't understand. My wife was the one who helped. I depended on her for everything.
You would leave your child?
My child will be happier in the arms of a princess.
I thought you were dead!
Not completely. Are we ever?
As far as I'm concerned, you are.
Is that true?
It's because of you all this happened.
I strayed into that garden to give your mother a gift. And I foolishly took some of those beans for myself. How was I to know? How are we ever to know? And when she died, I ran from my guilt. And now aren't you making the same mistake?
No.
Aren't you running away?
No more questions. Please, no more tests. Come the day you say what for. Please, no more.
We disappoint, we disappear, we die, but we don't.
What?
They disappoint. And I feel forgive the day.
No more riddles. No more jests. No more curses you can undo. Left by fathers you never knew. No more quests. No more feeling. Time to shut the door. Just.
Running away, let's do it. Free from the ties that bind. No more despair or burdens to bear out there in the yonder. Running away, go to it. Where did you have in mind? Have to take care, unless there's a where, you'll only be wandering blind. Just more questions. Different kind. Where are we to go? Where are we ever to go? Running away, we'll do it. Why sit around beside? The trouble is some, the farther you run, the more you feel undefined. For what you have left undone, and more, what you've left behind.
But we disappoint, we leave a mess, we die, but we don't.
We disappoint in turn, I guess, forget though we won't.
Like father, like son.
No more giants waging war. Can't we just pursue our lives with our children and our wives till that happier day arrives? How do you ignore all the witches, all the curses, all the wolves, the lies, the false hopes, the goodbyes, the reverses? All the wondering what's even worse is still in store.
As I've ever been. There remains a part of me that
continually needs more.
I have on occasion wanted more, but that doesn't mean I went out in search of it. This is how you behave as a prince. What kind of king will you be?
I was raised to be charming, not sincere. I didn't ask to be born a king, and I'm not perfect. I'm only human.
I think you should go.
Me? But I do love you.
Consider I've been lost. A victim of the giant.
Is that really what you mean?
My father's house was a nightmare. Your house was a dream. Now I want something in between. Please go.
I shall always love the maiden who ran away.
And I, the faraway prince.
They're almost finished! You see over there between those two trees? When the giant comes, we are to send her over there!
Good.
I wanted to climb the tower too!
Well, I'm glad you're here to help me. What's wrong?
My granny is gone.
Oh no, I'm so sorry.
I think my granny and my mother would be very upset with me.
Why?
They said to always make them proud, and here I am about to kill somebody!
Not somebody, a giant who's been doing harm.
But a giant's a person too? Aren't we to show forgiveness? Mother would be very unhappy with these circumstances!
Mother cannot guide you. Now you're on your own. Only me beside you. Still you're not alone. No one is alone. Believe me, no one is alone. Sometimes people leave you halfway through. Others may deceive you. You decide what's good. You decide alone. But no one is alone.
I wish.
Wait until my mother hears I've slain the giant.
Jack. Your mother is dead.
Dead? But she killed by the giant?
She was arguing with the giant, trying to protect you when the steward struck her a deadly blow from behind.
Oh no. Why would he do that?
He was afraid she was provoking the giant.
Can no one bring her back?
No.
That steward will pay for this. After we slay the giant, I will slay him!
No, you will do nothing of the kind.
But he shouldn't have killed my mother, right?
I guess not.
Then he must die.
No.
Why not?
Because that would be wrong.
What he did was wrong! He should be punished!
He will be somehow.
How?
I don't know. Stop asking me questions I can't answer.
I'm gonna kill him!
Then kill him! No, don't kill him.
Mother isn't here now.
All things, right things.
Who knows what she'd say?
Who can say what's true?
Nothing's quite so clear now.
Do things, fight things.
Feel you've lost your way.
You decide what you
want. You are alone. Believe me, no one is alone.
No one is alone. Believe me.
Truly.
You move just a finger, say the slightest word.
Something's bound to linger,
be heard. No one acts alone, careful, no one is alone.
People make mistakes.
Fathers,
mothers.
people make mistakes,
holding to their own,
thinking they're
home. Honor their mistakes,
for their mistakes,
makes
one another's terrible mistakes.
Witches can be right,
giants can be good.
You decide what's right,
you decide what's good.
Just remember,
someone is on your side,
someone else is not.
Let it go.
Things will come up right now.
We can make it so. Someone is on your side. No one is.
She comes! Just remember, don't let her know our plan!
Where is the boy? Where he is.
Over there! You see that tower where the birds are clustered? Jack is hiding in that tower!
Thank you. Now justice will be served, and I shall leave your kingdom.
Maybe
I just wasn't meant to have children.
Don't say that. Of course you were meant to have children.
How will I go about being a father with no one to mother my child?
Just calm the child. Look, tell him the story of how it all happened. Be mother and father. You'll know what to do.
Alone?
Sometimes people leave you halfway through the world. Do not let it grieve you. No one leaves for good. You are not alone. No one's alone.
Son!
Into the woods to fear in midnight, into the woods to find the wolf to eat, the witch to hunt, the giant. to climb, to heat, to find, to lead, to teach, to join, to go to the